Hi my friends, how are you? I hope everybody's fine. My name is Daniel Villarino. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In the video that I made of the hourglass, I received a comment by a subscriber that goes by the fictional name of Jon Targaryen. And if you have seen the series Game of Thrones, you will understand why I say that it is a fictional name. John was telling me in that comment that that was a very sad day for him because he had to sell his lathe because of economic reasons. And he told me that if to raise his spirits, I will do a video with something related to the series Game of Thrones. I have been thinking about different things related to the series, and at the end I came up with the idea of making a box with the shape of a dragon egg. The dragons are an integral part of the series, so I think this is going to be pretty much something that will represent the series. And it's something that I can make on the lathe. I've been working in PowerPoint and I made this drawing. First, what I did, it was to just grab the image of a chicken egg and I draw it in PowerPoint there. I don't know if you know that chicken eggs and dragon eggs are basically identical in shape. The only variation is the dimension. And then I part the image in two and I move it apart to leave the space where I'm going to part the base and the top of the egg, and of course make the recess that is going to fit on the base of the egg. And I also draw there the tenons to hold both parts. Afterwards, I kept working on that image and I did this, which basically shows several steps that are going to give me an idea of where to rough the shape, and then it will be just a question of following that line and smoothing it in the shape of the egg. So this is one of the components of the project, and for that I have this piece of walnut which I already mark the center there and there approximately because it's not perfectly round. I'm going to rough it in the shape of a cylinder, and from there I'm going to work according to the diagram. This piece of course includes the pit of the log, and many times the pits are kind of troublesome because there is where the cracks and the checks begin to expand, and in many cases you don't want that. In this particular case I am not too worried about that for two reasons. The first is that on the top of the egg I'm going to make a hole and put there a finial that will represent the tail of the dragon. I don't know if you are aware that the dragons, when they emerge from the eggs, the first thing that comes out is the tail. And then in the bottom, if there are any cracks, I guess it will just add reality to the idea of the egg cracking and the dragon emerging from there. Besides the egg, I'm going to make a round circular shape to support the egg, and that shape will have three legs. And of course, the finial on the top representing the tail of the dragon. So the project is going to include several components. I am not sure if everything is going to fit in just one video. If it gets too long, maybe I will split it in several videos. Before I go to the project, I want to show you there, I have a new sticker. Peter Brown from the YouTube program Shoptime sent it to me. Thank you, Peter. I appreciate that a lot. And if you have stickers from your shops or your programs that you want to send me, just send me an email to the email address that appears on the description down there and I will send you in turn my sticker. And if you want to check Peter's page, I will put the link also down there. He has a phenomenal program, very nice. If you are not subscribed, I recommend you to do it. So now, yes, I hope you enjoyed this video. Let's get to work. Please always use adequate protection for your face and lungs. I'm going to use a 3/8 of an inch ball gouge. I am going to make several grooves with a diameter a bit bigger than 5 inches. These grooves are going to serve as a reference to leave all the cylinder with a uniform diameter. I make sure that one of the faces is really straight. I transfer the measures of the tenons and each of the steps to the cylinder. I take in the caliper the largest measure of the dovetail tenon. Now I use a skew chisel to shape the dovetail. You can see that the jaw dovetail shape is a perfect match to the dovetail shape of the tenon. You can also see that there is a clearance between the end of the tenon and the bottom of the jaw. This way, we guarantee that the contact is going to happen between the tenon shoulder and the most external part of the jaw, providing a good seat and hold it. On this side I have too much wood, so I am roughing it out
to work more comfortably. Since this first step has a smaller diameter than the tenon, I'm going to leave in the most external part of the step a larger diameter, so that it will serve as a shoulder to the tenon, and then take the rest to the measure that appears in the diagram. This second step has a diameter of 3 inches. That will give them continuity.
Thank you.
Before parting the piece in two, I thin as much as possible the excess on the tailstock side. So once I have separated the egg top from the base, it will be easy to cut this excess and leave the tenon ready for the chuck. Now I can proceed to cut the top from the base. I use a light to monitor the progress. I continue this way until the union is thin enough to be easily cut with a handsaw. A way that I find easier to hollow from the end grain is to initially make a central perforation. Since I am at it, I will use the largest Forstner bits that I have, but even a smaller diameter perforation will help. I mark the bit to have a reference for how deep I want to do the hollowing. With a sharp, round carbide cutter, I made cuts in the bottom and in the internal wall. With the parting tool, I did a recess on the internal side of the lip where it will sit the tongue of the lid. I already sanded from 120 up to 600, and I will apply abrasive paste and friction polish to finish the interior and as far as I can go in the exterior. The process for the top part of the egg is similar to the one for the base. Thank you. I test the fit of the bass and the lead. To eliminate the tenons, I will hold the pieces by the mouth using the call jaws. In the bass, I will make a 1-inch and 1/2 recess to install my logo coin. Since I will glue the coin with its flatter face towards the outside, the coin itself will serve as a base of sorts that will allow the egg to stand. Still, in my next video, I will prepare a nice base for the piece. These beautiful bronze coins were made at www.coinsandpins.com.
Okay, my friends, I finished making the box with the shape of a dragon egg. You can see the interior there. Very nice wood. At the base I have here the coin with my logo, and you can see that this walnut, the heart of the log, is darker, is the hardwood, and then the softwood, or the area of growing, is a lighter color. And if you look it this way, you can see the growing rings around. That's because this was a log in this direction, and that gave the effect of these particular bands. And with the lines of the grain that you can appreciate there. It gives the egg sort of like a mythical aspect, which was the intention. So now it remains to make the finial, which I am going to try to make with the shape of a dragon tail, and then a base where the egg is going to be supported with three legs, and those three legs are going to be similar to dragon claws. And one interesting thing is that because I put the logo coin there, then there is a flat area, so the egg can stand like that. So now, if you allow me, I would like to show some pictures that have been sent by the friends of the channel. This fire hydrant was made by Santiago from Toledo, Spain, in Iroko and Arizona, Cyprus. It is a gift for his son who is about to take the test to be a fireman. Good luck, and Santiago, great work. These mortars and pestles in olive wood were made by Alejandro in La Paz, Canelones, Uruguay. A gift for his son's birthday. Happy birthday, and Alejandro, excellent work. José Luis from Zamora, Spain, has made this beautiful segmented platter using pine, cherry, chestnut, and sapello. Beautiful platter, José Luis. Heinrich from Santiago de Chile made this replica of a paraffin lamp with eucalyptus, pine, and roulis, and it is hung using a train track sleeper bolt. Great job, Heinrich. Ana Agustín from San Antonio de Padua, province of Buenos Aires, Argentina, made this beautiful box in Guayubira. Excellent, Agustín. And here, let me show you some pictures of the dragon egg. Okay, my friends, I hope you enjoyed the pictures. I put there also some pictures of the dragon egg, and I hope you enjoyed the video. And if that's the case, please mark the like button down below, make comments, and if you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, please do so. And it will be until the next one. Cheers!